Our forefathers, then they talk and say, who won't drink clean water? No, they abuse river. And onto that level, now they welcome to another anxious better program where we call UAC Soccer Life Lines. Today, oh no, as usual, I get my goons. Then they with me inside the studio. I get Kofi the Guru inside the house.
Yeah, you know, we're just taking over the management of the Super Eagles now. We're hoping to make a very fantastic work with it. Very fantastic effort. You know, we're going to bring in the principles that we used in Tunisia 94 and then the ones we took to USA 94 and make sure that this year we conquer all odds and we make sure the Eagles fly once again. So we're back on board. Congratulations, Nigerians. We're back on board.
So you follow them now for the team?
You know, Ulisse is my man. You know, you've always known that. You know, so let's not go about the bush about this. No, Ulisse is my man and we're back in the camp. We're going to make sure change is here.
Yo, always a pleasure to be here. How you doing?
I did fine. And then all of that we did here, you can also not forget, saying that UAC make this one possible for us to be here for Una today. So make Una not just go anywhere, we'll come back. No, make we take this message from UAC.
Live your life in color with the trusted paint brand that offers the widest range of colors and delivers a professional finish. And now you can picture it before you paint it with the free Dulux Nigeria app. Live your life in color. Dulux, let's color.
Now still USC Soccer Love Lines, and then when I don't hear, I'm just like the guru TikTok by himself there. Incident don't take over the job.
Yes, the change we will be praying for is finally here. You know, Nigerian football has suffered a lot of setback on a few months and probably like 2-3 years now. So finally that we're back in the process. There are ideas that we've been keeping to ourselves. They didn't allow us the opportunity to talk about it and bring it on the table. Then finally that we have the opportunity now, we're going to bring that to the table. And we're going to be working with very, very structured hands. All we need is structure. We're going to have to show them the tactics. You know, we're tacticians and we have technicians in this field. But we've never been given the opportunity to display what we have. But finally, we're here. My wife all the way from Tunisia, she's going to be coming home to join me as well. it's sometimes coaches do not have the family comfort to be able to provide.
No, don't stop programming.
We'll deliver this time.
Okay, thank you so much. We're not here. Christian Chukwu.
No, stop programming. We just stop programming.
Christian Chukwu. Austin Agwabo. Samson Siasia. Steven Okechukwu Keshia. Now, Sunday Olise.
No, you said the last man standing. Mm. This is the only man they've always left out, and finally, this last man standing, and the last man standing is going to get the job done. So, definitely, yes.
Okay, but then, Biola, what do you think about this one when they pick Sunday Olise? In they qualify for the job. In Sabi, they getting it take to coach Super Eagles. Which clubs they mean don't coach before for us to say would they carry a whole national team? We get plenty wahala. We get plenty storm where they don't they face. Mm. You think so? Listen, at the right man.
Well, the first thing is he qualified? Yes, I think that is eminently qualified. For us to play the game at the highest level. UEFA Pro License, which is like the highest level you can go to in the UEFA coaching program. And only very few coaches are actually, you know, across the world have it. But I see your point when you mention the fact that for somebody who is about now to take over a national team job, he has absolutely no experience. His only experience was a couple of years ago when he coached a Belgian third division team, you know, for a few months. So that really is all he has in terms of getting his hands dirty. The other things that we've seen that has enamored a lot of Nigerians to him has been his brilliant punditry. You know, during matches, during the Nations Cup, during, you know, the World Cup. I think that was what exposed people to his level of intelligence. But again, when you mention the fact that saying it and doing it
now, two different things.
Ordinarily, you will advocate for a situation where the coach that you appoint to handle a national team as big, as prestigious as Super Eagles of Nigeria should have some sort of experience. But again, experience teaches us that we've seen managers who have taken over big jobs with no experience. Rare, exceptions, but they have happened anyways. And I've gone on to do quite well. Pep Guardiola, which is like the biggest example, when he took over the Barcelona job, no experience, he was coaching Barcelona B, which really doesn't qualify as experience when you want to take over a team as big as Barcelona. And he did a marvelous job with it. Tito Villanova, who took over from him when he left, was his assistant. He wasn't the first team coach. Because to coach Barcelona is one of the biggest clubs in the world.
Yes.
You know, and Tito stepped into the role, you know, and he did a massive job, you know, as well, despite the fact that he had serious health challenges, which ultimately, sadly, you know, took his life. So my thing about Sunday Oliseh is, yes, Kessié had a lot of experience. He won the Nations Cup for us in 2013. But since then, what has happened? Our football has been on a steady decline.
Sorry, make I quickly cut you there.
Yeah.
That place, as you just talk about now, people will coach Barca,
yeah,
then coach, then get players. Barca get boys.
Well, that's
who we get for our national team. Why are you where they say
very,
you
very, very, very valid point.
Now, the way I'm going to comment about this is that you use the word punditry. That's the use of words, language, and all that to express knowledge. And when you say intellectual, you see, at this point of change, what we need is to redefine our processes. You know, it's not about being technical and then you cannot have some finesse to it. All of this Barca you're talking about, there's some finesse to the game. Now, and Olise coming on board is bringing some finesse to the game. You see, one of the reasons why we hardly win is because nobody looks forward to the press after the victory. Our presentation after the victory is never so good, so the boys don't care to win. But when they have an Olise, coach who can
because
speak,
he won't speak French. Now French will go chop.
No, don't speak English.
Now French will want
chop. We know if you have a very good rapport with the press, you can come and represent your country fluently and eloquently.
Sure.
I'm telling you, it's going to ginger the boys.
Yo, I'm going to tell you this.
It's going to ginger the boys.
From this point of view, I like Olise. I like the way he dresses. I like the way he carries.
Yes,
I'm telling you.
We need that.
I'm telling you. You might find it surprising. But the way he carries himself in a very, very
now he's
going to
be a role model for the boys.
He speaks very well as well.
See,
you know, the former manager, for instance, 4 years into the job, the first thing you hear is that we are building a team. You know, you didn't think that there was a structure to what you were doing.
But Olise recently still talked saying no be the Messiah.
Yeah?
Why not talking before then give him the work?
No, see.
I don't know why you don't want to trust my man.
No, any manager that takes over any big job in the world will say to you that I've come here to do my best and I hope that my best will be enough to win us titles. No manager will take over the job and say, all of them are going to sleep for hours.
Let me finish my point.
Where to be your point?
My point is this. You see, the man that represents the body is enough to encourage others to want to follow. When you look at the panache, the finesse, the courage of one. See, and one thing that we missed in the team is that there has been no consistent passes over time. And the greatest football passer ever in the history of Nigerian football is Olise. Olise looks at you right there, and a Mikel Obi will never get there.
you don't bring Mikel again.
Part of the matter, I say, Olise don't pass ball from Lagos. Gumi Persi for Abuja.
Did
you hear about that? They passed the ball from
the moment
here. Somebody chested it at the airport in Abuja.
The moment Olise looks at you, he knows where you are, and that's what we need. The passing culture, not the greedy hold ball and then you don't deliver. No. So if Olise can bring that into the new vigor and the team and say, okay, this is how we do it. You have to play, you know, this formation, we have to do this.
Yeah.
You have to toss the ball this way. You have to, you know, don't play the Ghanaian style of dribble, no score. No, you have to distribute the ball. You know, share the ball. You know, it's a beautiful thing Olise knows how to do. So we need that for a while.
What?
We don't need to win titles. We need to build up. Then maybe another coach comes and then wins that.
Let me just
but we need the build.
And let me just quickly add to that as per, you know, we lacking outrageously talented players like, for instance, Barcelona and a few other clubs. I concede that, yes, in terms of individual quality, we've had far better players, far more outrageously talented, you know, gifted players. But what I do feel, and one of the things that marked Olise's, that has marked his life, because if you look at Olise, the way he has conducted himself since he retired from football and all that, you can see that he's a very organized person. You can see that he takes himself very, very seriously. A lot of our ex-internationals are, you know, they frittered away their money. All of them are dependent on Nigeria and talking about why Nigeria owes them and all that. He's moved into another level. He's respected across Africa. I met him in Abu Dhabi in 2013 during the U17 World Cup. He was on the FIFA Technical Study Group. I mean, you should see him.
He's a learned man.
I mean,
see, we need learned intellectual.
He's accepted at this level even without having coached, you know, because he carries himself very well. So I think that he's the kind of guy who can look at this job, It's a difficult job, I concede. He will look at the job, he will see what the job entails, and he'll give his best. Another thing that I say about Olise is that he looks to me like somebody who can focus. One of the problems with Stephen Keshi was that he focused on a lot of the wrong things, fighting battles here and there.
Nah, the familiar spirit.
A lot of all those things.
Monitoring spirit.
Olise looks like somebody who can
a gentleman.
Like, what is our objective?
A gentleman.
Our objective is to qualify. What do we need to qualify? We need to win 4 games. How many home games do we have? We have 3. So we need to win. You know, you bring a bit of intelligence, and you can share it with your players and say, guys, come, we need to win our home games, but this away game at Soso Place, I think that we can win. You know, you start to paint clear, vivid, unambiguous, unequivocal.
You don't start.
Yeah,
you don't start.
No, my man. Today, I permit you to use all the, you know, all the words.
Bulos. You know.
You don't start. Spurious. Use the word spurious.
You know, pictures are not spurious. Pictures that are illuminating, elevating, that edifying, that uplifting.
It is allowed.
Those kind of pictures.
For Olise,
are the things that he will paint, and I think that is a new vista for players. Because make no mistake about it, in Europe, these players are used to structure and order. When they come back home, I've been in a lot of training sessions of national teams. A lot of the times, you are disappointed at what you are hearing that the coach is telling the boys. You'll be hoping that maybe there's another training session that you don't attend, that they are telling them the truly technical stuff. Because if not by this one, where you stand, they hear, oh boy, now wow.
And
so
you know,
that's what I see. I see Olise will be very organized, he's very focused, he's very, very detailed, he's very intelligent, and he'll bring all of those personal attributes.
Okay. You know, the boys will be treated the way the coach is treated. I'm seeing Olise, you can't treat that.
No, but my own be say, now NFF go allow Olise to walk.
They don't get choice.
Because for some people, they talk, say, Imamado, man no man. Now you make them bring Olise.
Let me tell you something. One of the misrepresentations of Keshi was that the NFF did not allow him work. I can say it here that Keshi was probably the most backed Nigerian coach. First of all, Keshi got paid a lot of money, 5 million naira per month. Second of all, under Keshi, Nigeria played probably the highest number of friendly matches we've ever played. We were playing friendly matches all across the world. There was no FIFA. We played against Italy. We played against Mexico. We played top-class friendlies. Those were the things that we used to complain about. This was a Stephen Keshi that was heavily supported as to giving a free hand to invite any kind of player
that's
that he
why,
wanted.
That's
so
why
he was giving. So what I'm saying, what I'm.
That's why flavor nobody.
And the flavor came and brought no flavor.
I brought absolutely no flavor. So the point I'm trying to make was that the NFF, as it was constituted then, actually supported Keshi. It is a misrepresentation to suggest that they did not support him. No, they actually put a lot of their resources behind him. But whatever it is that happened between them happened, I think that Keshi was still caught in that space of when you always be suspicious of the officials and you paint them like villains and all of that. I think that this president of NFF, the first thing about giving somebody a free hand is to respect him and to trust his judgment. I think that this NFF have shown clearly that they respect Olise. And when you respect somebody, naturally you respect the judgment, the professional competence of that person. And I think that those two things are there. If he's achieving results, why do you want to control him? Problem starts when the results are not coming.
See,
he's making the wrong decisions.
Right now, it is the dispensation of change. I trust my man. Nobody's going to do it.
Now your man.
Olise, don't take over, man.
Anyway, like,
better recognize.
the three people where they say they stubborn self for national team that time, where we say them be the boss, then they take charge.
Yeah.
Mafia. Siya Fulu. Keshi, that number two. We listen at the third person.
So which is
the
right man? Which is right man? I say these new players, know them they stubborn.
Because
now the stubborn was the coach. No,
make them.
Make them put my brother.
Then go happen. See, we'll get back.
All right. Now the thing when they be that with, they say congratulations to Sunday. Listen, and then we hope.
Yeah, what do you think?
Anyway, make we just look because my own. I just think I say. Olise, we never see him coach. Make we see what he need to do.
No wahala. That's
so make we just the watch and see.
Yeah, so yeah? First time.
Yes,
man.
Make we see what he need to do. All right, make we just quickly take the short break. When we come back, we go enter the next level. We'll be photo of the week. We will check eye for what thing they happen to our boys. Then no go anywhere.
being the foremost property developer in the country, UPDC is perfectly positioned to help investors take advantage of this growing opportunity. Our structures are renowned for their exceptional aesthetic value and their phenomenal returns on investment.
Our vision is to be number one real estate solution provider in whatever market that we have chosen, and we're going to continue to try our best to ensure that we do all that we do to remain number one in this segment.
If you enjoy urban living at its finest, then our fine selection of luxury apartments are for you. Take time out to browse through our property portfolio, and we're sure you'll find the ideal investment choice for you. UPDC, building for sustainable value.
Our people, they talk and say, no how when the nose won't be rich, when danger come, you know if you smell them. UAC Soccer Lifeline, the Obonga program, where you they hear all the etchetram things them will concern the world of soccer.
They don't say I played that ball as goal for where, for my mind.
As one guy won't score, boy, no score. Make a come open mouth, say, ah, man, I for score this ball. Now, if let's say, talk. Say, ah, if not me, I for score this ball. Now, they look, Mika, you say, wait. Mika say, I for score this ball. Now, shut up. IFLA, continue. What were you saying?
UAC Soccer Lifeline. My name is Dayo. Make a catch you for TV, nothing, Mika. UAC Soccer Lifeline be the program where we just still there on top and then quack quack quack. Photo of the week, the guys then when I get their photo here on Nazi and then Inyama. Finally, because of waiting Inyama talk, it come be like saying Miss Yan that time.
Yeah.
Finally, God don't touch NFF mind. Yeah. They don't finally forgive the guy.
Perfect resolution.
And then on Nazi for the match where we play against St. Chad.
Yeah.
He misplay.
Yeah.
Yeah, then give him card.
Yeah. Do like
that. Yes. Because sometimes I know they understand.
Forgive Inyama.
Then
watch this program. And then see reality.
Because we tell them as it be.
Say the koboko.
We for them.
You know, carry two mouths. You carry tentacles.
You know, this thing about that koboko. You know, the imported koboko. The koboko in Nigeria. He flog us that time with the drop in Yama. They put a in the
post. They put
the logo nation's call.
There's a black pound soak and inside Ogogoro where they don't ban.
We don't ferment.
So then no. That one where they use for 300 is small. You see that one for 300, the guy do cha. The koboko travel.
Divide
it. He go Greece.
Come back.
Person, come back.
Spata.
Come back.
This one.
Now we see what happened to the Nigerian team.
I heard it, they got so.
Then you say, Inyama, we are seeing the Koboko. And nobody is our back.
Go flow. So God bless us.
So they come, they do say.
But really, come to think of it, this point where the guru they raise, now very important thing. Does it mean say no? So without Inyama, no national team?
Truth of matter, I say he's a very important player. And what happens with him? Most important players that you manage them. And I like I said,
no, but apart from now, I don't think saying Yama don't give them problems.
Generally has been very easy to manage. So what he said, yes, it might be out of turn. What he said might be provocative. What he said might have been out of place. But was it
the truth?
Well, it was the truth. But your job, okay. Your job really, well, the truth itself is subjective, but in some way there was a lot of sense in what he said. The job of the management is to look at your critical resources and manage them appropriately. So now that you are finally seeing the light, because all that stuff about him coming to come and fix a panel and all that
which
stuff
panel?
Was never going to work, and they were setting themselves up for it. And
now then they cause wahala for themselves, because if you don't come, wait till you go
to now
and as you don't come, so wait till
you go. So it good say they see common sense, because normally wait till you go, therefore say, you don't come at me, we ban you. If you ban them, next match will come.
Hi.
Whether or not you and your pot belly,
my
your enter post go
my
so I like the fact that they've resolved it. And it shows that this NFF,
they are ready.
They are thinking.
Yes.
In some of the decisions that they are taking, they are putting their ego aside.
Yes.
And they are trying to do the right thing. So I think that we criticize them a lot, but on this one, they need commendation. They deserve commendation.
That one person, way ahead, they always hurt quickly to the suggest. All these disciplinary
action.
One person, owner,
come on down.
Because now that one person, now they can't go to him and say, calm down. The guy, calm down. No, we have to deal with him.
He's going to jail.
That deal with him guy, that guy. Who does he think he is? That one person. Now one person, no. Now one person, they determine that thing, the others will come follow.
Because if you kind of enter this holy dispensation that we just came in,
we'll show you.
All right, my man is the Messiah sent. Because God rested on a Sunday. And yes,
Kofi, you not come, not the cause problem. This guy don't talk, saying
he not be Messiah.
I said Messiah sent. That's what I said. English, Messiah sent. The MSS, Messiah sent. See, Messiah sent Sunday. He was rested on a Sunday. That's why he sent us Sunday. Okay?
Okay. All right, Tom, we just quickly take message where people drop on top social media. And when we come back, we go feed them and say bye-bye. No go anywhere.
Supreme ice cream. Oh my goodness.
Sometimes following your heart takes a lot of sacrifice. Protecting your heart even takes a greater sacrifice of denying yourself the little pleasures of life. But the good news is, you can protect your heart without denying yourself the little pleasures of mouth-watering and tasty meals with Grand Pure Soya Oil. Grand Pure Soya Oil is made with high-quality soya beans rich in vitamin A and contains no cholesterol. So go ahead and eat to your heart's desire. Grand Pure Soya Oil is endorsed by the Nigerian Heart Foundation as the heart-friendly oil and now comes in a brand new bottle. Grand Pure Soya Oil, the heart-friendly oil.
Thanks a bunch of love now. We don't send us all the etc. messages then. Far and wide, we see all of our message. We could not continue to send them. And then for your screen right now, you can see on the scroll there for Facebook, just like our page on top Facebook now, www.facebook.com/UAC Soccer Laugh Lines. And then if you also you go see the YouTube own, that one for you to catch last week episode, or if you missed this one, just check on top of our YouTube channel. You go see I'm there for www.youtube.com/user/UAC Soccer Laugh Lines. Now there, now you go see catch all the etc. All right, so Biola, the last one you go just tell
us. Well, the last one, I said a new dispensation, like Kofi said, change in some sense is here. I think that we have a young man in charge, an intelligent man, somebody who I think will be focused, who will give the job all the seriousness and the intellectual power, so to speak, you know, that the job deserves. So I'm very hopeful, I'm very optimistic, cautiously so, but nonetheless optimistic and hopeful. And I think that, you know, over the next few months, we have a lot of interesting things to say as the Olise's reign as Super Eagles coach unravels.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been 21 years, and finally, another man who can take us there has been given the opportunity. So, my man, congratulations, Sunday.
Sunday is the day God rested and gave us this blessing. So Sunday is the day. Any match we play on a Sunday is a win. So henceforth, we must
so
fix
all.
Play
Saturday, we'll lose.
Yes, we must fix all our matches on a Sunday.
You must always spoil everything when you talk. You go find way to spoil life. This is the way you just talk now. Just spoil everything when you don't.
I go sit down and say we must find way all our match will play on Sunday because our coach name is Sunday. So if our coach name is Monday, then Monday we're going to
play our matches on Monday.
You have to say, I'm going to play my own name now. You're going to catch you next week. No good.